Welcome to Chemistry with Caroline. In this video, we're going to look at the nomenclature of aromatic compounds. So in these examples, the parent name is going to be benzene, and then substituents are going to be coming off that. When I only have one substituent, I don't need to use a locant because that's by default the one position. So this molecule here would be named bromobenzene. And then if I go over to this molecule, the substituent has 1, 2, 3 carbons coming off of it. So that's a propyl group as a substituent. So this molecule would be called propyl benzene. Many benzene derivatives are referred to by the common name as opposed to the IUPAC name. So I'm going to give you some examples of some of the most frequently used ones here because you'll see that as the parent name. So this first one would be methyl benzene, but it's almost always referred to as toluene. It's a common solvent, so you may have encountered it in lab. This second one is called anisole. It has a O methyl group on it. The nitrogen-containing compound is aniline. And with the OH group on it, it's called phenol. And lastly, this bottom guy is benzoic acid. And so all of these molecules, these are their common names, but that's what you're going to see most of the time in reference to this base molecule on the benzene ring. So now let's talk about an example where we have more than one substituent on our ring. With benzene in particular, you don't always use just numbering to dictate the spatial orientation. So if we think about a ring, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 kind of unique carbons when we have one substituent. And so this would be the next door neighbor, also 2, and then this one would be 1 away, also 3. So a 1-2 substitution pattern on a benzene ring is also referred to as ortho, or in naming, you'll just see an O to indicate the spatial relationship. A 1-3 substitution pattern is referred to as meta, and you just see an M to indicate the spatial relationship. And all the way across, a 1-4 is referred to as para, and you would see a P there if we were going to name a molecule. So here are some examples of molecules that have two substituents. The base name of the molecule is going to be that common name. So for the one on the left, it would be a benzoic acid. That's the highest priority group, is that carboxylic acid. And then it has a substituent, and if we number, we'd say 1, 2, 3, right? So start at your highest priority group and then number to give the next substituent the lowest number possible. So that'd be 3. So we could either call this molecule 3-methyl benzoic acid, and the methyl is going to go right up against the benzoic there. There is a space between benzoic and acid. Or we could say M-methyl benzoic acid. M meaning that the spatial relationship between those two groups is a 1-3. So when you see this OMP, that's referring to those two substituents. For this guy on the right, I have 1-2 as my spatial orientation between the two. The base name is going to be anisole, so that's for that O methyl group. So I could either say 2-bromo-anisole, or I could say O-bromo-anisole. And either of those would be appropriate, and they both indicate the same spatial relationship. Lastly, let's look at an example where we have more than two substituents on a benzene ring. In this case, we can't use ortho, meta, or para because that refers to two groups in particular, and which two groups would I be referring to? So in this case, you're just going to go back to using numbers for locants like you're used to doing from all the other nomenclature so far. So this is an aniline derivative. So my number one carbon, the highest priority, is that nitrogen-containing group. We would number clockwise so that we could give that bromine a lower number. And so aniline is going to be the base name. And then I put my substituents in alphabetical order, just like normal. So 2-bromo-4-methyl-aniline. So here's the parent name. It's a common name, as is frequently used for benzene derivatives. And I have my substituents out front in alphabetical order with a locant in front of each one so I know where they are. I couldn't use ortho, meta, or para because I have more than two substituents. So that only works with two substituents. So this has been a look at how to name aromatic compounds. If you found this video helpful, please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Thanks.